All right. James writes, hello, Collider team. I'm a big fan of the show, and I watch while I run on the treadmill to help pass the time.
You run and you walk, and be honest.
Walk on the treadmill.
I was really looking forward to seeing Jeff Nichols' Midnight Special this weekend. I love his previous film, Take Shelter in Mud. I thought it opened everywhere on the 18th of March, only to be disappointed to find out that it's only in limited release, LA and New York. I live in Michigan and have no idea when it will play near me. My question is, why do some films such as this open in limited release and then slowly expand? Why don't the studios release the film? Why to begin with? Thank you and keep up the great work.
Money for marketing. It's just they could lose money marketing a smaller film. It's just it's harder to do it. I mean, we're just talking about Kiss Kiss Bang Bang. Studio had no idea what to do with that movie. Didn't know who to market it to, because even though you might want to go see a Midnight Special, it might not have that great audience appeal, and they might do these polls and asking audiences like what the anticipation is. That's why the smaller films have done better with the direct to TV releases and these streaming releases. That's why you see more of that now, and that's why just we're talking about with David Ayer going to Netflix, more people are watching these smaller films there because it costs a lot of money to go to the movies now. It really does. So they're picking movies like Batman v Superman or the big summer movies to go see stuff, and the smaller movies kind of get left in the dust here. So that's why the studios don't spend that much money to put them in wide release, because it costs more money for them to do it. Mark?
It's very interesting, though, because when you see the trailer for Midnight Special, you're like, this could be like a big budget summer tentpole movie. You look at the cast, where the premise is, but that's not what Jeff Nichols wanted to do with his baby. And James, I have some good news for you, is that you're in Michigan, right? So it's in more limited release, or less limited, I guess, on April 8th. So you can make the 3-hour drive from Kalamazoo, wherever you are, over to Chicago to see it, or April 15th, it's going to be everywhere opening, along with The Jungle Book opens that day too. But Midnight Special, I'm with you, dude. It was in limited release in LA and New York, and I wanted to review it, hopefully with Christian, and I was going to go see it, and I couldn't find a theater here to go see it. It was playing at one theater at midnight, and I'm like, well, I'll be drunk by midnight, so I didn't go see it, and I had to wait. I might not get to see it this weekend, because we got all that cool WonderCon stuff, so I might see it the same day James sees it on April 8th.
I'm going to see your special, Drunk by Midnight. I'm going to see that in theaters. But the other answer, Treadmill, is, you know, they do these kinds of
treadmill
releases. They do it. They did it with American Sniper, where they release it early.
Early, right.
And they do a limited release, and we always knew that it was going to go wide, but they did that because they wanted to have that Oscar consideration. With something like this, they're still doing that limited release, but what they're doing is they're gauging how many more theaters they're going to want to add to the already. So it's limited release. They see how all the, you know, the bigger cities react to it. It's already scheduled to get a larger release a little bit later, but they can always add or subtract in that area. So unfortunately, you have to wait a little bit, but it'll eventually come to you.
You think, and the thing also with the Oscar push, a lot of those times you'll get those that will drop, like Revenant, by the way. Revenant came out here in like New York and LA in December limited, and then they push it wide in January and February. Movies like this, to where it drops now in March or April, whatever, wherever the hell we are. I don't know what is this, March still?
March.
I don't know.
What is this, Russia? This isn't Russia.
So anyway, it's to release it at that time. It is a matter of what the audience is saying, but I think streaming is really going to change the game, and I think that's why this box thing is starting to cause
guys can see Midnight Special right now. Come out. $10, man.
What, you got an ice box there? I'm going to go. I'm only showing up. Hand-cut ice from you, son. Then I'm
hearing
there.
This movie's great, by the way.
I am, too. I cannot wait to see it.
This clip, click here to watch the entire episode. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, because it'll help you stay up to date with all the stuff we've got going on here at Collider.